Today we have a last lecture about group perspective of multi-agent system and agent technology. We consider methodology, how to build multi-agent system from point of view software engineering, how to engineer such a system. Well, in many cases it will be only like add-on or addition to existing methods of software engineering, rather than completely new approach that replace all previous one. So we consider what are perspectives from a multi-agent system point of view in engineering or software systems that we have to take into account when we design such system. But what we have today? Today we consider what our approaches to engineering of multi-agent system, but we start from consideration where actually, I remind you, where agent-based solution appropriate, because not in all systems it's necessary to consider that we use multi-agent system approach. It can be just traditional system engineering. And then we consider three methodology, putting more attention to this Gaia and agent UML, and briefly only considering this Kini AAI methodology. Very briefly, we consider application formal method in our agent-oriented software engineering, and then some pitfall in agent development that you have to be aware when you engineer a system like multi-agent systems. Today's lecture is related to chapter 9 in textbook, but in this case I also strongly recommend you to read this paper, because I only briefly present Gaia approach here, and in textbook it's only mentioned, but here are all details about the approach. This is available on web, and this is also available on web, even if I didn't give you here a URL, I think that there is a URL in web page. It's about agent UML. So I provide you necessary information about the methodology, but it is not well presented in textbook. So in order to understand it better, I would recommend you to look into original papers. Okay, but before we start to consider software engineering of multi-agent system, I remind you what we considered last lecture. And in last lecture we considered that we may have different architectures of multi-agent system. You remember blackboard-based architecture, actor model-based architecture, market-based architecture, and so on and so on. When we have such architecture, that actually one approach would be how to map our problem to this architecture. We do not consider how to build the whole system from starting from specification to software development and so on, but we already have some system and we just map our problem specification into architecture of this system. It is not general approach that we consider as the main focus of today's lecture, but actually it is one of possible approaches how you build. So in many cases you do not start from scratch when you work with multi-agent system, you have already some system. And when you have system, you already have some constraint how you can use it. And then when you have constraint how you can use it, you can consider how you map. And as an example of such approach, I again remind you Agora systems that we very briefly considered last lecture. And this is not actually part of curriculum, but basically it is one of example how we can consider methodology for building multi-agent system when we have already multi-agent system architecture. So, if you remember, basic idea of Agora system is that there is a generic marketplace called Agora. A marketplace provides different functionality. First of all, of course, this is matchmaking. It can be advanced matchmaking with semantic, with some other thing. But it is functionality of matchmaking plus any other tools and components that can help us to work together. For example, negotiation protocol, that you have already marketplace where you have some built-in approach to negotiation. For example, action, English action. Or you can build another and so on. Approach of Agora is that you build such points for negotiation, then agent register to this point. There are some default agents that are built-in agent in the system that provide some system functionality, but you can override everything. So what you have in this case? In this case, you have a structure of your multi-agent system as a network of marketplaces and agents. Okay? So basically, you can imagine that you have your agent and agent communicate, and this is your multi-agent system. In case of Agora, you can, okay, they communicate directly, but they can communicate also via some common place, like marketplace or like DF in J. But DF is very specialized and only with matchmaking. Here you can provide different functionality. How we can use it? We also consider very simple methodology. And I do not put it as a main element of our course because it is bound to our system, but not as a general methodology. But anyway, it's easy to start because any systems that we consider as a multi-agent system, they already provide, as I told you, some template or some pattern how you can use it. What are elements of such methodology? If you have problem, find first identify participants of this problem. What are agents? Identify cooperating points where agents can coordinate or negotiate their activity. Okay? Map participants to agents. Map coordinating points to Agora. Choose coordinator and negotiation agent to be to identify for this activity. You can choose a different negotiation coordination protocol or any management. And then create agents in Agora. So, having some architecture of your multi-agent system, you implicitly already have a methodology how to use it. So in this case, how you build your multi-agent system having Agora platform, because there are a concept of marketplace and agent, find who are agents, who are, what are marketplace, map list, and then have it as a system. I remind you example also, virtual shopping mall. We have a virtual shopping mall in the internet, different shops, the customer who look for product, customer good, purchase good for communicating, by communicating with shops, the customer may negotiate about price or product. So, first we identify participants. Who are in this case? We just, what is the power of agent technology and agent approach? That it is naive and simple modeling. You do not have what could be your model. Just look who are in your system and find them as potential participants. If you have virtual mall, shopping malls, then who are they? Of course, customer agent. Of course, shop agent. Mall agent that will coordinate the whole mall. Marketing agent, maybe. This is already, we have to think. First are obvious. Customer, shop, and mall. This is what we have. Agent they are. Marketing agent. What else? We can think that bulk purchase agent, agent that propose, okay, let's we buy some product with a huge amount of orders and we get discount for that. But it's not enough for one. You need to create a coalition. Okay? Is it clear? Okay. Multi-product purchase. Maybe you have to create some package and then you can see how it works. And price negotiation agent, of course. So what we identify as the cooperative points? Coordination of mall activity. Coordination of different customer agents. Coordination negotiation between shop and customer agent. Coordination multi-product and bulk purchasing. Okay, and this is what we identify as our possible activity. So what we do next, we map participant to agent, map cooperative points to Agora, and then we choose what negotiation or coordination agent we need in order to implement this activity. As a result of such our analysis, we can have already structure of our system that is influenced by specification and problem and supported by architecture of multi-agent system. What we have in this? We have MOM-Agora, we have SHOP-Agora, as I already told, and when we have a shadow, it means that we can have more than one. Okay? You can customer Agora, you can Bau Purchas Agora, so directly you map them, and then you attach different agents. This is just to illustrate you. In principle, we can have quite big network that can contain different, we can after that extend our network with additional functionality that we can find thinking about what is our problem. For example, it is good that each agent may have more than one, each customer can have more than one agent. One agent to buy one thing, another thing to buy another thing, different profiles of agent. Or I buy as a person, or I buy as a member of organization, or buy it is business purchasing and so on. And then you can coordinate this all agents. The same for many agents, and then you can coordination between coalition of agents, and then the same for shops. Say shops can provide more than one agent for different companies, for different offers, for different types of products and so on. So this is how it works. Again, this is quite specialized methodology that used that consider what is structure of your multi-agent system and try to help you in order to map your problem into some system. And this can be also considered as one of methodology. Is it clear? Okay. But we are interested today in more general view to methodology, where we consider not specialized architecture, because okay, we have our system, somebody has other system, different system provide different methodology. We consider how can we engineer agent system independently, well, independently is a strong word, because you're always dependent on some assumptions. But as much dependent on multi-agent systems that you have operating. Or maybe you can just implement it by yourself using software development tools, but not any multi-agent system existing implementation. But before we start to consider this methodology, we should agree about terminology. Because terminology is a bit confusing. If you look into papers about multi-agent system design and software engineering, then there are many different concepts used. First is agent-oriented programming. Actually, it is not about methodology how to build multi-agent system. It's about how to program each individual agent using different presentation of attitudes and so on that we consider mostly next lecture. Then we have concept agent-oriented development. Actually, it has the same meaning as object-oriented development, but for agents. So it's a way how to develop using analysis, design phases, implementation, and so on. And then we have other words like agent-oriented software engineering, agent-based software engineering with agents that are all synonymous. And they consider, okay, they include like agent-oriented development, but they also consider reuse, maintenance, and some other components of software development. But you can see that I especially would put some division or separation between this and this, but not separation here. Because actually, you can safely use all these four terms in the same meaning. It's not a big difference. It's very tiny classification that some of theoretical work in software engineering provide. But basically, they all about how to engineer multi-agent system. And finally, we have agent-based computing that refer to methods of engineering of software mounting system, and also include application, how this area is applied to different problems. So, what I would like to say, this part is about how to build agent-based system. This is about how to build individual agent. And this part is how to use what we build. And this is why all these terms will be, I will use this one, agent-oriented software engineering, but in the literature you can find all of them in the same context, okay? So it's just a clarification that not for you to be confused what this is their separation. For us there is no difference, but there is difference between this and this, and between this and this, okay? Okay, so what we consider as agent-oriented software engineering is a set of concepts and methodology to support development and maintenance of agent systems. So we are interested to create methodology and tools that allow us to or enable development and maintenance of agent-based system. In some sense, this is similar to methodologies that have been successful for development of object-oriented systems. Approach that is applied in multi-agent system or agent-based software engineering is that we do not create something new. We build our methodology on what we have already in software. I don't know how many of you had already course in software engineering related. Okay, everybody, very good. So in this sense, we consider that we extend object-oriented software development to be applied to multi-agent systems. But before we consider this, when we need such new approach. When we do not need to, when we do not need to consider this, when we are quite satisfied with the standard approach to software development, first of all, we consider, and as I told you in first lecture, when we have open environment or at least highly dynamic, uncertain or complex environment, then agent could be used. If we don't have such open environment, don't try to use agent technology because it will not give you benefit. Also, when agents are a natural metaphor, when you have problem to create model of system, and the easiest way to consider system is just as a mapping of reality to concept of your agent system, then it is good. As in our case of when it is mostly appropriate. For example, when we already have a good methodology developed, like shopping buying, like organizational structure. When we have already organization of elements, then we can also use them in agent-based approach. When we have distribution of data control and expertise, this is in addition to what we can see, because distribution of data control and expertise may be also in other systems. And when we have legacy system, if you remember, this is a situation when you have some system that is old, nobody knows how to change it, but it is important for organization to use it. So approach that we considered previously as a wrapper approach or Archon approach, you remember, allow us to improve interface of old system in order to use it for a new system and for a multi-agent system. So if you have this element in your problem, then try to apply agent-based solution. If you don't have them, don't try. This is my message. So do not look into a multi-agent system that it should be used everywhere. They have their own niche, It's quite big. It's not very narrow niche, but it is broad application area. But main points for this application, looking at the open environment, dynamic, uncertain, and complex environment, natural modeling, distribution of control, first of all, and when you have legacy system. These are points where you can look into multi-agency. Okay, now why we cannot use existing system or existing approach that already we know, just to apply them for multi-agent system? The problem is that we already considered. Agent compared to objects are flexible and, most important, autonomous problem-solving element. They have autonomous behavior, and previous previous approaches like object orientation doesn't consider an autonomy as a special element of design. Okay? And agents have also much richer interaction possibilities than objects. You remember the difference between object and agent, that object doesn't decide if it allowed to invoke some method or to allow or not allow to invoke method. If you define something as a private, no control at all, everybody can invoke it. Yeah? In agent, each invocation is request. And agent decides itself to satisfy this request or not, depending on its internal behavior, constraints, knowledge, and so on, and so on. So it's you send request, but you do not invoke particular method without any constraint from agent. So different that agent has the control over its behavior. It can even deny your request. Is it clear? Different, yes.
Why has the object-oriented design do the same thing?
What we consider is object-oriented design. Any multi-agent system you can design as object-oriented system, using object-oriented system. Yes, but then it's like any system you can design using machine code. And this means that, but there is no notion in your object-oriented design or in machine code that support you. You have to create it. Our point that we would like explicitly introduce this into our design methodology, that we use it. This is all, but please, it's a good question that you ask, that please understand that all agent-oriented system, at the end, they are implemented as object-oriented programming. But in the same way as it is implemented in any machine code. We consider different levels of abstraction. It's only different. But of course, nobody denies object-oriented programming. We just say that there is something that is missing and we would like explicitly introduce it in order to improve our possibility to create system. Okay? This is all. But of course, no question that even you can consider Jade, it's implemented purely in Java with object-oriented things and so on. But in addition to what is in Java as an object-oriented tool, they provide some additional things. You can consider the development of APIs, but problem is that we consider already which APIs you will develop. Okay? So, if we have this, what we consider as a methodology, then we have analysis and design. And basically what we have models and guidelines how to use this model. So our methodology that we consider will be which model we need in order to apply our methodology and what and how we use this model. And it will allow us to understand particular system and design system. And basically, as any software engineering activity, what is one of main element of software engineering, any activity, is modeling, moving from one model to another. We start with some model close to application area and then move towards system area. And this we translate one model to another. So in agent-oriented model, we would like to formalize understanding that we can consider, or systems that we consider, and develop set of models where we start with abstract model and going to implementation. But what is important? What is implementation in our methodology will be input to object-oriented methodology. So we like have a preprocessor before applying software engineering object-oriented thing. And finally, what we have here, it will be either mapped to existing system, like in case of Agora, or will be input to your object-oriented development methodology. Okay? So, result of this will be requirement analysis model in many cases for object-oriented methodology. Okay? Okay. So, in case, this is just to underline, when I talk about implementation, it's not implementation already in terms of a real program, but in terms of that this implementation will be input to another level of engineering. Okay? Is it clear? If not, then ask now, because it is important. It's one of the key points in order to understand what we consider during. So, what we consider when we have software engineering? We have like requirement acquisition, then analysis, then design, then implementation, and so on, so on. Now consider, we start with already some level, let us say, consider that is called requirement analysis that we call after requirement elicitation. And this requirement analysis model will be what we consider implementation in our methodology. We start with some abstract model of how system should, what is application area, and move towards some models that is called implementation on design, but basically it is input to object-oriented methodology. Okay. If we consider this methodology, then they are can be divided into two groups. One group inspired by object-oriented methodology, and another group adopts some knowledge engineering or other technique. We do not consider this part. We consider only this inspired, object-oriented inspired. It will be very particular. We have very particular examples of system. Initially, I would like to create your understanding of context where we are working. And then we consider particular methodology. Okay. So we consider only methodology that is inspired by object-oriented methodology. And we also consider methodologies that can basically, especially these two, will be input for other method of design, of traditional software design. But in order to start, we start with one system called AAAI. Why it is such a name? Because it is Australian Artificial Intelligence Institute. And author, one of authors of this methodology is Keane and his group, and then aim to construct set of models when after elaboration they define agent system specification. What is important to underline with this methodology that while it is inspired by object-oriented technology and that it uses also agent class model and an instance model, that is, this methodology very tightly coupled with approach for building agents that implemented in this system, and it is based on so-called BDI, Belief Design Intention Architecture, that we will consider later. So it is oriented only to some particular methodology of building agents. And this is why it was one of the first methodology, but it is quite, let us say, restricted, applied in quite restricted. What is this methodology? That when we consider a multi-agent system, we have two views external and internal. External is considered agent and communication between the agent, and internal considers internal element of particular agent, like beliefs, desire, intentions. Again, we will consider this later and don't put much attention. There are some special things how we implement particular agent. So when we consider external models, then we have agent model and interaction model. You can see that whatever methodology you select, there is always two components, agent and communication, interaction. In Agora it's also, but it's provided by special thing. Here it is pure agent and interaction. And for agent, we consider agent class model and agent instance model. Class define types of agent, and instance populates particular case. So how it is applied? For example, we would like to use or to consider system where we have some weather monitoring, and we would like to inform about current weather condition to some agent. So first, what we start with, we start with identification of relevant roles in domain. We have roles, and these roles we decide. What are our roles? One is weather monitor, one is weather consumer. So one monitor weather and make information aware about weather condition of another. So we can consider that we develop roles and we develop class hierarchy for these roles. When we identify roles, then for each role, we identify also services that are required by these roles and provided by this role. And for each service, we determine goal that is associated with such service. For example, for weather monitor agent, it will be find out weather condition current or make other agent aware about it. So what we consider what are roles, what services these roles provide, and for each service, we identify what goal is behind each of these services. Okay? So we define role weather monitor, where the consumer. For each role, for example, for weather monitor, we define there are two services related to that weather monitor provide, and for example, one service is finding current weather condition and making aware. So, in other words, we define services and we define interface to these services, and this interface or specification of the service is called goal. What is goal? In order, which goal this service satisfies. You remember last lecture, we have this goal, sub-goal, and so on, so on. Idea is to program in the same way. We define goals. For each goal, we provide services that implement this goal. But it's important also to say that goal can have sub-goals. And this sub-goal can be presented as a plan and context condition. For example, plan for make another agent aware of the weather condition will be send message to this agent. And finally, we have atomic facts or action to be performed. For example, in this case of AAII methodology, they are based on belief structure, but for us it's important to know there is some facts related to our goals that will be finally grounded and instantiated. For example, temperature. It will be some this temperature is aware, then it will satisfy some plan will go, and this goal will be promoted. Okay, this is quite abstract, and I don't want that we spend more time on that, but just for you to know that there are possibility to create such methodology based on roles, based on services associated with this role, and with services associated plans, and with plans associated actions and facts. But we do not spend too much time on that because of it is quite oriented already or tightly coupled with the methodology how to build particular agent, and this is has already some limited application. The next methodology that we consider is general purpose methodology. It doesn't consider that there is any system or architecture or whatever related. And this is called Gaia architecture. One of author of this methodology is Woolrich, who is also author of your textbook. The motivation that the existence of the methodology do not support agent, in particular interactions, and agent organization, and it borrows terminology mainly from object-oriented analysis and design. And what is important, it considers that we build agent system as society of agent, we have organizational design. What does it mean? We will consider later. So when we consider systems, we consider that we have some organization. And what organization is? It has roles, it has some structure, and so on. But we will consider this in more detail. So, Gaia methodology is general because it's applicable to range of multi-agent systems. What is different with, for example, Agora AAWI. And it is comprehensive because it's also considered both societal and micro-agent aspect of system. And what, again, this methodology, it is based on the same idea as object-oriented development, program requirement to implementation. But implementation in our case will be input to another system. We have abstract model and we then have a more concrete and particular concrete models. In Gaia model, methodology, there are a set of models. And this set of models presented here, we first of all have some requirement statement, and this requirement statement come from application area from your customer. Then it has, again, role model and interaction model. And this is what we consider as analysis part. Design part that we consider is includes agent model and services model that is part of role model, and comes from role model. And we have service model and acquaintance model that is also related to interaction models developed earlier. Abstract concept that we consider in our system, in the Gaia methodology, are roles, permissions, responsibilities, protocols, activities, liveness and safety properties. And they used during analysis. And there are also concrete concepts that used in design, like agent types, services, acquaintances, and so on. Let's go into more details. And now consider a role model. What is role model? It has different attributes, and these attributes are mentioned here. First, it is permission, so rights which are associated with this role and resources that are associated with role. So we define role and we define what this role can do. What are rights and what are resources? Activities. Activities that are what type of communication or what computation can be carried by this role. Okay, we define permissions that are rights. We define activities that are computation. We define protocols that in compared to activities are computations that engage interaction with other agents. Okay. And we can have responsibilities. And responsibilities, there are two types of responsibilities. One is our type is liveness property, and another is safety property. And liveness property is state of affairs the agent must bring out. So it, in other words, it say what agent has to do. Okay? And safety property, these are constraints that agent has satisfied. For example, temperature in your nuclear reactor should be below, 500 grade, degree or something like that. So we have what are right of agent, what activity or computation agent, the role, sorry, may have, and what are interactions this role provide using different protocols, plus what activities are, how activities are connected to each other in order to provide some useful computation intuitiveness property, and safety property, they are constrained on activities that should be satisfied. Okay? We will have example, and this will be much more clear. A role model is composed of set of role schema, and each role schema define what is this role about, what are protocols and activities this role use, what are permissions that right associated with the role, and what are responsibility of each role in terms of liveness and safety properties. Okay, I think that now it's time to have a break. Do you have any questions about this? In the second part, we consider this methodology further, and then we have example how this methodology